Welcome to the Tuned In Podcast, a podcast all about music and interviewing artists to find out what connects them to the music they create. Hosted by myself, Nick Brohall. I have a passion for music and want to get artist stories out there to connect people to the thing I love most, music.
You may be wondering, where's your glasses, Nick? Well, the lights reflect off my glasses, so I'm taking them off. Lucky you. Nick? Why do you make videos that are so depressing?
That's a very valid question. Maybe I should spice it up.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to episode... What is it? Episode 7 of the Tuned In Podcast. And you may be wondering, why are you so jipper? Jipper? That's not a word. Ooh, hats off. Is it fixed now? Oh, goodness, no. Can't tell. All right, you gonna see me without hair? Ugh, messy start. Oh, dear. I don't know which way to turn. Oh, my goodness. Okay, well, this isn't going as planned. All right. Welcome to episode 7. Of the Tuned In Podcast. Thank you all for the support on the last episode again. I know it was a much deeper one, so everyone's probably wondering, why are you so happy right now? Because with music, it's not all about just being sad. There's also music that just makes you happy. And so this episode is all about a song that makes me very happy. It's called Why by Dominic Fike. It's just an upbeat song that's just super groovy, and I love it a lot. It's just super short, super quick, and it just makes me feel good. It's just like something you can groove to. I'll play 15 seconds starting now. And welcome back. Did you see me dancing? That's because I already knew I was going to be dancing. Because I have moves. Some would say like Jagger. Some would say like a dying cat. It's up to you to decide. But personally, I think it's like Jagger. If you think otherwise, you'll hurt my feelings. So, what can I say? Okay, so the song Why by Dominic Fike makes me happy just because simple, it's just upbeat, you know, and it just kind of like gets me going. It just makes me like, and I just feel happy when it's playing. One of the moments that just makes me happy about it is just that the album came out recently, and so it's fresh and new in my mind, and I've obviously been struggling with my mental health all this year, and it's been tough, but this album that it came out on, I think it's called What Could Possibly Go Wrong. Gosh, is my hat still messed up? What Could Possibly Go Wrong? There we go. I don't like it. Nope. There. Perfect. Okay. Perfect. And it's just such a good album. It's just upbeat. It's nice. He's just got such a nice voice. And I just have happy memories of just playing that song in the car after a rough day at work. Just, you know, not saying that work is unenjoyable. Just, you know, everyone has their days, right? And I just have my days mentally. But just singing that at the top of my lungs on the way home, just so freeing, so fun, just so amazing. And it's just one of the better feelings. I love when music makes me feel that way. And I have so many songs that actually make me happy. And, you know, not every song has to be about, you know, death, suicide, or anything of the sorts, or have to do with just being sad. Like, music just encompasses everything. and the stuff that can come out, like, that just has that happy feeling and that good vibe, you can tell when someone records it and they're just having fun. And that's what I just felt like was happening. And, like, another favorite memory that I have is, like, when I'm driving someplace with, like, my girlfriend and we're singing it at the top of our lungs and we're just, you know, having a good time. It's just super fun. It's a song that means a lot to me. It makes me happy because I feel like, you know, 10 years down the road, and if I have a kid by then, which I should, I think, I don't know, I could be presumptuous, or even two, who knows? I don't know. Who knows what the future holds? But, like, in 10 years, 1 to 2 kids sitting in the back seat, you know, and I could just see them as little kids jamming to this song because it's just fun. It's got a nice beat. And I could just, you know, imagine telling my kids that, like, this song reminds me of when I was 23 with your mom grooving in the car. And I just think that's great. And I think having fun with music and having these nice memories is also so important, other than just having songs that are there for you in your darkest times. It's having songs when you're feeling happy make you feel happier. And I think that's something I'm learning a lot along the way of my life, is just that it's to just take advantage and not take it for granted when I'm feeling happy. Because there's so many days where I can feel sad. So it's just capitalizing on the happiness that I feel, and just enjoying and being grateful for everything in life. Because it's just like when that song plays, it's just so, like, melodic and just peaceful to me that it's just like it reminds me of the best times, like just having fun, like enjoying my life. Because at the end of the day, no matter how much money or how much anything I have, like, it doesn't, like, necessarily matter. Because it's all mindset, and it's just like this type of song is just fun and silly. Like, the meaning is just like asking a girl, like, if she ever asks why, like, why she, because, like, you know, everyone deals with, like, the whys of life, like, but some people don't even question anything. They just don't ever ask why they pay for this apartment, why they work for this boss, why they have this boyfriend. And he's just like asking if you ever wonder why, any of the stuff, or do you even question anything? And but, like, the way he goes about it is just kind of, like, funny in a way that it's, like, silly, fun, and just exciting, and it's just something I enjoy a lot. And I hope that you guys get a chance to listen to the song, or, like I said, I hope you guys share your stories about songs that either make you happy, got you through tough times. Like I said, got a message, not message me, well, message, email to nick@thegoagency.com. And then I can talk about your stories. Or if you'd like, you can come on the show. Also email me. Don't be afraid. I don't bite. If anything, I'll be more uncomfortable than you. And that's just because that's me. either way, I would love it if people could come out, you know, tell their stories, because I think that's important, because I may be relatable to some people and it may be great that I talk about certain topics, but I don't cover every aspect of mental health, because I can only truly talk about what I've experienced. And I know I haven't experienced everything. Otherwise, man, my life would be a lot different than what it is. So I'd love to get everyone's perspective of, and then also, my music is heavily influenced by a lot of different genres compared to some others. Like, gonna be honest, I don't listen to country music, like, at all. Like, ever. The only song I know is the one about turning the lights off and locking the doors, or something, something, something. Don't hate me, by the way. That's just me, personally. But if you love that song and it got you through the darkest time, or it makes you feel happy, come on down, or email me, and I can talk, or you can talk about it, and I can talk about it for you, and we can share in this experience of music and this thing we call life and mental health, and really just make it so that it's not such a stigma and it's not so taboo to talk about, because music is so universal that, like, people here in America that don't understand a single word of K-pop can listen to K-pop and love every second of it and not understand a single word. And I'm the same way with Corridos. I know I said that very white-like, but in the Mexican culture of music, that genre or reggaeton, super awesome. I don't understand the words, but they make me feel happy. They make me feel different types of ways just because I like how it sounds and how things are. And I just think music is so universal that we can all relate on so many levels that I think it's important that we all can tell our stories about our mental health and the music we love so that we can all come together and, you know, help solve some of the mental issues that we're going through and kind of put them out there to the world so that everyone knows that you're not alone. That no matter what, something that helps me, like, I know I've got a great support system, but something that I also know I have is awesome music to listen to for whatever I'm feeling. Happy, sad, mad. I don't know. I don't really have any other moods other than that, really, I guess. But whenever I'm having those moods, there's songs that can uplift me when I'm feeling down, as I've already talked to about in the previous two episodes. So share it with me. Okay. I don't know how long this episode was, but I hope you enjoyed. I hope it was more thrilling, the fact that I'm a little bit more upbeat, not talking about something so serious. Well, sort of. But I hope you guys liked it. If so, let me know. Yeah. Thank you for tuning in. Dad joke. Bye. You ever wonder why?